Hand prop it.
For pilot preference and redundancy, so if you're right or left-handed, you use the one that suits you. And if that one were to ever have a failure, you could use the other one. It's the exact same controls. Yeah, so it's all flight.
It's up to 55 knots.
Okay, so the current aircraft is really started as the Black Fly, and you have a new aircraft coming, which is called what?
The Helix.
The Helix.
We're currently taking pre-orders for the Helix. It's basically the better version of our Black Fly. We've taken a lot of feedback from our customers, and we're hoping to incorporate all of that into an aircraft that fits everybody's needs.
Okay, so can you tell me some of the differences?
Yeah, so we're hoping to increase the pilot weight, and we basically have a system that's more robust, and we've done a lot on the inside. So for me as a firmware engineer, I know that we've like upgraded all of our boards. We're trying to limit weight of the electronics in order to get better interiors in the aircraft and just things like that, things that make it more of a product.
Okay. So right now the pilot weight is 200 or 220 or?
Currently we're at 200, but for Helix we're going to be at 220 pounds.
Okay, and so you're not so big, so you don't have any problems
with
that.
No, and the good thing for me is that means I get a little bit more range.
Good. And so the aircraft comes apart and it fits in a trailer, like a 16-foot trailer?
Absolutely. I don't know the exact dimensions, but both of the wings come off and they basically fit parallel to each other, and then the fuselage goes in right next to it. I was a part of some of our testing, and we're hoping to get to have one person be able to build the whole thing in 30 minutes. And I don't know, I got pretty close with our first pass of our design.
Okay.
Which is pretty cool.
And so the batteries are all in the wings close to the motors.
Yeah, every motor basically has its own set of batteries. And because of that, we're able to basically be able to tolerate a motor failure. And so when any one motor goes out, if it's detected, the other motor will compensate by turning itself off to maintain stability of the entire aircraft.
I see. And that means that heavy wiring to get the power to the motors is not going any farther than necessary.
Basically.
Everything you can to reduce the weight. And so
exactly.
where are these things made?
We make them in our offices in Palo Alto, in California.
And it's mostly carbon fiber?
Yeah, the entire fuselage and all the wings are made of carbon fiber.
Okay, and is it like baked or in an oven, or have you watched them put it together?
I've seen the molds and everything, but I'm not super in touch with the manufacturing side of things.
Okay,
but yeah, whole thing is carbon fiber. We've been making them in-house, and we're hoping to improve our processes to make sure that all of the aircraft are.
Okay, so and you're doing the firmware, and I know there's some kind of phone app and.
Yeah,
we have
our Helix app, and so you can connect to it on your phone, and that helps you kind of go through all the pre-flight checks on your phone instead of having to use the viewscreen or our flight panel.
Okay, and there is a display and two joysticks.
Yes.
I heard someone say that if you're right-handed, you use the right one, and if you're left-handed, you use the left one, and
exactly.
Either one will work.
Yep, absolutely.
And it's a redundant system.
Correct. Yep. And so, yeah, exactly that. Basically, we have two joysticks. You only need one to fly. All of the whole thing is fly-by-wire. It's basically, if I want to go straight, I point straight. If I want to go up, I push the thumbstick and I go up. And hopefully when you use the simulator, you'll see how easy it is.
Okay.
But yeah, you only need one joystick to fly. You can also change mid-flight if for any reason something were to go wrong.
Okay, that's great. Very good. Thank you, Tina.
Thank you.
Can I go, you can go higher. So push the thumbstick to go higher. There you go, and you should see your altitude increasing. And now what I want you to do is actually push the whole joystick forward all the way, and you see how you're rising up the hover line? Go all the way, now squeeze the trigger. Keep going, keep going, keep going. And when you get to the top, squeeze the trigger and go through it. There you go, so now you're in cruise.
That's better.
Yeah, there you go.
All right. And it's not gonna descend or?
Nope, it's gonna hold your altitude. A bit of a glare, hello.
And where am I?
I believe this is here.
Okay,
yeah.
So yeah, I recognize where I am now.
Nice. So if you want to do a nice landing, I would say right about now, start to lower your altitude a little bit. Actually, yeah, up to you. Nice, there you go. And then when you want to actually land, we're going to transition back into hover. So you see how you're pretty close? So you're on that there. With the thumbstick, and you should see on the screen the word Autoland come up. There it is, Autoland available. So now while holding the thumbstick back like that, I want you to squeeze the trigger. Squeeze the trigger?
Yep.
And then also pull the thumbstick back at the same time. There you go. It's now auto landing. Nice.
Wow.
There you go.
I didn't crash. You know, I flew a 747 simulator and I bent up the landing gear.
It's a bit harder.
A full motion pilot training 747.
Oh my God.
And I bent up the landing gear, but it actually didn't have a real landing gear.
Cool.
That was great. What's your name?
I'm Josh.
Josh, thank you so much.
Oh, for sure.
Fabulous.
Let me get you out of the chair here.
All right.
That's still recording.